Your Royal Highness, the Duchess of Sussex, High Commissioner Nigel Casey, and Dr. Joanne Newman, it is indeed a great pleasure for me to welcome all of you.
In a moment, I will be handing over to Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Sussex. I'm very proud to say is the patron of the Association of Commonwealth Universities and is herself an inspiration to thousands of girls and women for the support that she gives to them and for the power of education to change lives. I'm very proud to have this opportunity to introduce our patron to so many inspirational change makers from this room.
Thank you all so much for having me. I'm really so excited to be here. Obviously, as patron of the ACU, it's been an incredible, almost a year now, a little bit over a year, really working to advocate for what is truly and deeply important and meaningful to me on a personal level. Education, I think higher education specifically, is such a key element for growth, economic growth, but also personal growth and development. You know, yesterday I had a really interesting conversation with someone about the economy of well-being. And so I think so much of what we should be talking about and the energies we focus on, specifically with ACU, is supporting people to know that if you don't have the support that is necessary so that you feel that you can keep taking the next step, then you're stunting your growth, right? And so much of that is, of course, having the support and scholarships and funding for students who are eager to learn. I mean, I went to university. It takes a village, doesn't it, to sort of piece it together for people to be able to finance that, get families chipping in, scholarships, financial aid, all those things that were the reason that I was able to attend university. But at the same level, you need to have that kind of support on the inside for educators to be able to give as much as they can back to those who are in the educational system. So it's very exciting today, and I will use a note card for this because, my goodness, this is the last bit that I can't screw up. very, very happy that we're able to announce today three new gender grants. This is key. Obviously, they are going to be in universities that are here, University of Johannesburg, Stellenbosch University, and University of Western Cape. And the goal here is to be able to have gender equality, to be able to support women as they are working in research and higher education roles, and also to be able to have workshops to convene things that are really helping people understand the importance of gender equality. You know, true to what you said, when a woman is empowered, it changes absolutely everything in the community, and starting in an educational atmosphere is really a key point of that. Separately, we are announcing four new Queen Elizabeth Commonwealth scholarships, which is very exciting. Students from Tanzania, Zambia, and Nigeria have been selected to study in South Africa next year. And I think what is so special about this, and part of what's incredible about the Commonwealth in and of itself, is you have 53 countries, all so varied, but with this Commonwealth, right? With this universality that connects all of us. And so with students being able to study in a cross-cultural environment, not only are they able to absorb the knowledge in that community, but they're able to bring that back home with them to really elevate that knowledge. So it's a really exciting day. I'm thrilled that, you know, given the context of what's been happening in South Africa with universities, which I've been also following very closely, that we are able to do our small part through the ACU to support so many people who are just eager to learn. And the only way that we can make a difference in the world is if we're receptive to learning and sharing that information as we have it. So thank you so much for having me today.